Hi, it's Jess Pryles from Hardcore Carnivore, and I've teamed up with Beef Loving Texans to show you how to master smoking a huge tomahawk steak. Did you know that a tomahawk steak is actually the same as a ribeye, just with a longer section of bone? What I'm trying to say is, this recipe will work with really thick cut ribeyes and cowboy steaks too. Let's get to it. So here's my massive tomahawk steak. It's over 2 pounds in weight and over 3 inches thick. A showstopper steak like this can feed 2 to 4 people, or one beef-loving Texan. Because of the sheer size of this steak, I'm going to be using the reverse sear method. So I'm gonna smoke it until it's nearly cooked all the way, and then give it a super aggressive sear to finish off that crust. The first step is to season, and I'm using Hardcore Carnivore Black. I'm gonna apply a generous amount all over the tomahawk and be sure to get plenty on those massive sides. Next, I'm going to put my tomahawk into a smoker preheated to 250 degrees and let it cook until it reaches 125 degrees internal temp. When it comes to cooking steak, it's all about temperature, not time, because what we're looking for is that perfect level of doneness. And there's a lot of variables. What's the weather doing? What are you cooking on? Even the meat's a natural product. But the one constant is temperature. So here are some handy numbers in terms of finished internal temperature. Rare is going to be 120 to 125. Medium rare is going to be 130 to 135. Medium is going to be 140 to 145. And well done will be anything over 150. I'm shooting for a perfect medium rare finish, so I'm pulling this steak 10 degrees below that to account for residual cooking and the sear. Now that the steak is nearly cooked the whole way, I'm going to cover it with foil and let it rest for about 15 or 20 minutes before I sear it. And that means I'm not going to have to let it rest again, so as soon as I've finished that sear, I can dive right in and start eating. Speaking of the sear, let me show you one of my favorite hacks for getting an epic crust. I've filled a chimney half full of charcoal and placed a rack on top. Concentrating the coals like this is going to create an extreme vortex of heat. Now I'm going to take my rested steak and sear it over this chimney for less than a minute per side to get an incredible crust. It's really such a cool technique. Be a little careful not to knock the rack over, and don't forget to sear those massive sides too. Just look at that epic crust. And now the part you've all been waiting for, the finished product. Edge to edge perfection. Perfect medium rare with that dark contrast crust and a gnaw-worthy bone. Keep exploring the Beef Loving Texans channel for more great beefy recipes.